on the internet at 3 o'clock this morning.
My declaration of war against the United States of America and its allies. Until every last foreign soldier has left Georgia, this war will continue on American soil and around the world, claiming the lives of the aggressors. The scales of power have been newly balanced, and we will no longer accept the tyranny of the United States.
Blame the U.S. media for their part in spreading Combine Nikoladze's message. Ironic counterpoint to the situation at home, U.S. soldiers in Georgia and Azerbaijan have spent their fifth night without combat. Though tensions remain high, military intelligence has been unable to locate any remaining Georgian commando. Have dramatically increased their efforts to find Combine Nikoladze. U.S. intelligence is combing a constantly expanding search radius extending from Georgia. Each new country, another possible secret alliance with the...
Because what we have here is a situation where further airstrikes just won't do any good. Nikoladze Army, if that's what you want to call it, is a bunch of...
As mourning relatives prepare funeral services, America's law enforcement and military forces prepare for the unknown, waiting for Combine Nikoladze's next move.
Kalinatek Building, Langley, Virginia, USA, November 1st, 2004, 0124 hours. Recover the encryption key. Russian mercenaries have begun to destroy evidence of Georgian activities at Kalinatek. Before her detection in the network, Grimmsdotir discovered that a technician named Ivan is hiding in the building. Ivan possesses an encryption key that could help Third Echelon find Nikoladze. Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell in First Person Perspective. This is a post-gameplay voiceover. As much as I, enjoyed playing this mission, the problem is there was some mix-up at the input level, like at the software level, and the game, the recording just did not catch any of my voiceover. It instead just, patched in a crappier version of the game audio into the, microphone audio, and hopefully I have fixed that now, but I honestly don't know. So yeah, this video and the next two videos are going to be, voiced over, at least this video and the next two videos. That being said, I was really excited about this mission, and I did get to, exploit the tactical shooter first person mod quite relentlessly in this mission. But yeah, that's we're dragging this out for too long already. Yeah, let's get this.
Fisher, your mission is a man named Ivan. When Grimmsdotir got made in Kalinatek's server, Nikoladze's mercenaries got spooked. They're pulling up stakes, wiping out all evidence of their presence, including Ivan and his comrades.
Who's Ivan?
One of Nikoladze's geeks, a programmer.
They're killing their own men.
It's all evidence. Let's pray you find him first. Details on your opsat.
It's a real pity this is the last time that we get to see this guy.
This is as close as we get. Are you sure you're cool with the details? This last-minute stuff bugs me out.
I'll figure it out.
Well, be careful.
I've already got a mother, Brooks.
Oh, Sam. So anyway, yeah. I'm excited about this mission, in case I haven't told you guys already. And, I'll get to shoot loads of bad guys here. Although this is gonna have a few, uneven cuts here and there, primarily because of how I spent a lot of time just, doing nothing but having fun. Just basically how I play games, but yeah. And for some reason I just decided to take out the lights here, but it does not work. These guys are still, pretty well lit. Luckily, this level has no alarms. And I guess that's just one of the reasons why I like this level so much. Which is not something which I can say for Abattoir. I mean, I like the shootout aspect, but that mission has
a
stealth requirement.
Came down directly from Grinko.
Yes, if I didn't fear him like the Reaper, I'd be long gone.
He told me to think of them as sheep. He says we are seeing the flock.
And yeah, getting the drop on these guys is pretty easy. But as you can see, it's not the easiest thing in the world to shoot people, even with the, you know, first-person tactical shooter mod, despite the narrow field of view that you get. And that is one difficult computer language. Anyway, I'm just trying to recapture whatever I had said before. See, one of the reasons that I really like the commentary while live commentary during the gameplay is that it's natural. It doesn't, you know, have to be forced, sort of like I am doing right now. And this is where you can drop off if you're speedrunning. You'll lose health, but yeah, it's a faster route instead of having to go all the way over there.
West wing of pit 1 is clear. Moving on to 6.
How many encryption keys did you retrieve?
This is our 7.
And another thing is that it's pretty easy to pull off stuff like this, you know? Running jumps and acrobatics and things of that nature when you're using the third person mod. I was searching for ammo there. I don't know why I always search for ammo there, even though there never is.
You can see his brain.
Make sure that you get off the first section there, because if you don't, then for whatever reason it just, you know, decides to break on its own. Nobody shoots it. I mean, if you start firing shots, it just breaks. I mean, I guess that's just the way they employed the game logic. I did not mean to, you know, deploy a stick cam at that moment. I was trying to zoom in, but I forgot the ADS button, which is actually scrolling the mouse wheel. As simple as that. But yeah, I forgot all about it. And at this keypad, I don't know what happened, but I entered the correct code the first time around. It did not accept it. The second time around, it somehow magically accepted it. Ah, I see, it was 97521, not 31, accidentally hit 2. I don't know how that works, but yeah. Now, this time around, a little more calmly, and we got access. And I started to play basketball at this junction, which I decided to cut out. Now, one of the things that I don't understand about this game, I mean, I do understand to an extent that they wanted you to play stealthily and use the avenues provided to you, the most stealthier avenues, in order to play this game. But if you are going to design a level, why make it so that you can't play by any other means whatsoever? Because as you see here in a few moments, after we kill these guys here, the door that you can see in front of you, that's actually locked. And there's no way to open it. So you just have to crawl through the vents nonetheless. I'm guessing they just get those guys there so that, you know, it would be difficult for us to make our way through this area if we're not stealthy. And again, this is one of the problems with this mod, is that sometimes, you know, you accidentally pick up bodies when they're near other things, because you can't exactly see what you're interacting with, since you need to be like super close to it. But at any rate, I will be trying to kill everybody in this mission. These are mercenaries, I've got no moral qualms with this either.
The fort clear. Three encryption keys retreat.
The art files. Thank God. Make sure you leave the bodies where the fire will get them.
I really wish I could save these people, but yeah, unfortunately you can't. So I don't know if this glass is breakable or not, but there are random people. Why do you say I'm in here like that? As if, you know, they're in the toilet and somebody, you know, knocks on the door. Like, why that statement? Anyhow, yeah, as you can see, like, even the sway has greatly decreased. I mean, typically it would sway like yay, but you know, yeah, with the first person tactical shooting mod, even the sway is quite greatly decreased. I mean, this mod lets you shoot, and I plan to exploit that to its fullest in this very level. Disarming the wall mines, on the other hand, is a little tricky, because if you get too close to the wall mines, you can't see what color they're flashing. Luckily, they have made sure that you can actually disarm the wall mines from farther away. And it's not something that the mod provided us with, it's just something that, you know, the game has done. There's a medkit in here, and I decided to just, you know, check out the rest of the rooms as well, to see if there's anything at all in there of value, which there doesn't seem to be. Moving on to the next section, next stage that is. I mean, if you're trying to pull off more stealthy, pull this off more stealthily, it's typically a little more difficult.
We just sussed on but the door out of Ivan.
There's a group of mercenary programmers alive on the third floor.
They're trapped behind a cluster of wall mines.
You think they might have encryption keys?
It's worth checking.
Yeah, so if you want to play this mission stealthily, it's actually more time consuming, but if you go in guns blazing like this, it gets over in a fraction of seconds. But then again, I guess that's true for every single game out there. You just gotta slow down for the stealth. And yeah, if this was more of a, you know, live commentary thing, I might have included all these scenes where I was exploring the entire place. But I don't really see the point of doing that with the post gameplay commentary thing. So I just decided to cut them out anyway. Yeah, this section is also quite straightforward. Just head into the room there and rescue these technicians in exchange for the door code. Now, I actually tried this level one time before, and not this level, like this section of the game and this section of the stage. And yeah, like I was saying, I mean, it's very difficult to see which color the wall mine flashes if you're too close to it. So I tried it before, and I sort of died. I was shooting all the wall mines out, and I probably must have missed one. So yeah. So I'm basically retrying this section again.
I need an encryption key.
We don't have any.
Why should I believe you?
There is a bomb.
What?
The Spetsnaz planted it to destroy the data archives. But they put it right next to the gas pipes. It will take out this whole floor.
How do I get there?
You will need the keypad code for the door. I think it's 33575.
Grim, check the building.
So this is Spetsnaz.
That story about gas pipes holds up.
I'm on my way.
Make it quick. You don't have a lot of time.
Yeah, so I'm a little curious about what they mean when they say Spetsnaz, because I mean, as far as I know, they're supposed to be the Russian elite forces, but yeah, just look at me. Just look at me. So yeah, they're supposed to be the Russian special forces, but apparently that is not the case. I mean, they can, apparently they can be, you know, just Slavic mercenaries, I guess, from anywhere around that area. So, unless you know exactly where all the wall mines are and take your time destroying them, which would take a lot of time, you just need to sneak through this level anyway. I think you can, like, do the tactical rule through the fire without harming yourself, but I have not tried it, to be honest. So, here we are. It's a slow and tedious process, but yeah, you just gotta slow down near the wall mines so that you don't get blown to bits. Like I almost was, and these things have some range. I mean, you saw how far I was from that wall mine, but I still managed to get hurt. Well, whatever works, I guess. And just to make things more tense, they added a sixth of the lock here. I believe this is the only one that you'll find in the game, which has six tumblers in total. Then again, in their defense, these are the archives. So, yeah, I can see why they would need to keep six. Need to make it a very secure lock.
Great work.
Although, I mean.
That could have been bad.
But we've got a new twist for you. I hacked into the power grid. Somebody's thrown the breaker on the fire door circuit.
Meaning you won't be able to open the doors until you found that breaker. Details on your offset.
Yeah, so like I was saying, I don't really see the point. I don't know why Sam Fisher makes it sound like he's having an orgasm every time he takes a health kit, but there you have it. Anyway, the secure door does not seem to provide much of a purpose when you've got glass walls for the room with gaps in between them. But anyway, I guess that was security oversight, if that is what they were aiming for. But yeah, I'm gonna take this guy out silently. That is via hand to hand, and I'm just gonna shoot the guy at the bottom. One of these people actually carries a satchel, which I will find out later on. Which is sort of sad, because apparently you can't exactly. So it's not this guy, it's the, apparently the guy who comes over later. So, yeah, apparently you can't bypass this section without taking, you know, certain people out. But at any rate, I decide to... My apologies for all the quick saves, but I decide to, you know, play around a little, do a little social experiment, if you will, and plant a wall mine here. Which actually ends up backfiring because it does not work at all. But yeah, the one which I plant here, on this wall, that definitely works. Also planted at a lower level. And I like how the wall mines can be planted at a higher or a lower level. Although I don't know whether that makes much of a difference or not. But just to be safe, I go ahead and take lights out. Not just one, but I think total 6 lights. 2, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 5. And a 6th. Should have taken the lights on, lights out on the other end though, but yeah, whatever works, I guess. One of the things that I like about this game.
Maybe our intruder. I need backup now.
So that is the fourth guy in the equation who, you know, involuntarily shows up. Sorry, invariably shows up. No matter how many other people are in this section or not. But yeah, these guys right now they're just walking, not running yet. But for some reason, when the first guy comes out, he takes off running. And I'm guessing that two wall mines combined is too much for that poor little chap to handle. Anyway, you can see his charred body still burning when you exit the section. Exit stage right. Or was it stage left? I don't know. I guess it is stage right because it might be left. Probably left, yeah, exit stage left. Frag grenades, medical kit, and some 5.56 ammo. And that's that. That is like a field save, which we need to trigger so that we can basically access, gain access through the fire doors. Or so I'm guessing. I've never, you know, tried to see what happens without doing that. As you can see, there's a charred body right there. And that's the guy that we need to, you know, at least knock out in order to get his access codes. Which I don't find out until, you know, who's going to be. It's taking a long time to, you know, just circle around. So yeah, I try the door, it does not work. and I just need to, yeah. So try the code here, 33575. It does not work because it is a 4-digit code. I always forget this particular mission and well, basically the particulars of this particular mission if you want to be a little cheeky about it. But yeah, I also find it strange how in this game they don't wake up the guards that have been knocked out, because that was an actual thing in Chaos Theory. I don't remember whether that was a thing in Pandora Tomorrow or not, but they used to do that in Chaos Theory. I mean, every time a guard found another guard, they would wake them up and ask them what happened. They both would get alert and start searching. This was often accompanied with an increased level of alarm. If alarms are worthy. Now, this is what I was talking about. Like, there are some random places with bulletproof glass. Like, this glass for the waterfall. I mean, who in the right minds decided to make it bulletproof? And apparently there's like a frag grenade just chilling out on the table. On a coffee table. Like, why? I don't know. Who kept it there? I have no idea. But you need to keep your weapons close, you know? Like, that's a little reckless. You know, home safety, office, health and safety, they might have a little problem with that. Anyway, moving on. Again, I am, you know, exploring most of these areas. I already know there's nothing in the room on the right. I probably should have, you know,
can you talk?
Moved over to the other side of the sky.
I don't want to die here.
Are you Ivan?
Who? No. It hurts. Please. Take me to the infirmary.
And that sound is a little strange, you know? Like, an entire second after this guy keels over, do we get that specific sound? And I just wish there was a way to save him, but there isn't. I mean, even if you do take him to the infirmary, he just dies anyway. So this is, there are like a few details which I really like about Splinter Cell in general, at least the older trilogy. And
do you have an encryption key?
They took it. Destroyed it. They've gone mad. I don't know what...
I need to find a man named Ivan. He's locked himself behind the building's fire doors.
Then he must be on the fifth floor.
That helps. Thanks.
So tired.
Yeah, so one of the tricks that you can use to see if somebody's dead or just knocked out is to turn on your thermal goggles. And as you can see, his body still has color, it still has warmth. But I actually waited around for like a minute because I could see it disappearing. And sadly, this guy just goes into, you know, I guess the doctors would call it an anaphylactic shock. I don't know if that is correct term for it, but yeah, this guy goes into shock and due to blood loss, and he dies. He dies in the end. He bleeds out, and it's sad. I mean, I sort of wish I could save him because this guy is just a technician. He's done nothing wrong, but apparently you can't save him.
Bullet, I think I found something useful. A computer with a window that says fire emergency system. Bullet, are you there?
So I just want to ask you guys a quick question. Do you think having mercy on the enemy is a weakness? Because that is what essentially I made Sam do over there.
Good work. With the decryption, opening those fire doors cleared your path to Ivan, and it did the same thing for the Russians. You better make damn sure you get to him first. Update on your situation. To cover our asses politically, we clued in the FBI, and we're gonna have to leave Ivan for them.
So what am I doing here?
Ivan's a technicality. All we need to trace Nikoladze is his encryption key. Get that, and we're golden.
So yeah, I mean, that's an example of the bureaucracy involved behind anything of this nature. Like, there's always red tape and a lot of Askel.
We already checked this hallway.
We might have missed something. We'll check it again.
How could we have missed
Playing it cautious.
Somebody?
Listen.
Yeah, well.
Well, what?
Nothing. Hold on a second.
And honestly, I feel like that too.
Little boy's room.
Make it fast.
And I honestly feel like that slows down the procedure of a lot of things quite greatly. But at the same time, it also provides us with a framework for, you know, not abusing any power. But yeah, I mean, it's sort of a trade-off. I mean, a lot of things get slowed down because of it. And this guy couldn't even take a V in peace. Oh well. You never know that when death is coming to you. Especially when Sam Fisher was involved. Well, that was the last thing you heard then.
Are you Ivan?
Yes. You are American? You are police?
Yes and no. The police are on their way. Until they get here, I'm the only friend you've got. I'm not a very good one.
We have to leave. We have to hurry. They'll find us soon.
That's not my job. I'm here for your encryption key.
That wasn't the deal.
The deal still stands. The feds will get you out of here alive, but first you have to give me the key.
That wasn't the deal I made with the woman on the phone.
Listen, do I come to your job and tell you how to murder civilians?
What?
No. So don't come to my job and tell me how to do mine. The feds are on their way or here already. You're gonna be fine. Give me the key, or I can take it.
That wasn't the deal.
You're working from a very limited phrase book. Listen, just give me the key. I'm tired and I hate making people scream. It gets me down.
Here.
Thanks. And until the feds get here, find a better hiding place.
God damn it!
Fisher, and there's better hiding place.
It makes me nervous when you say that.
It's another stall. The top floor. We're gonna have to do some cleaning before the Osprey can safely touch down for extraction.
Go away! I'm hiding! What? Go!
I mean, this is the best hiding place this guy could find, apparently. I like how most of the music in this game is ambient, you know. Sometimes there are soundtracks, but for a lot of the game, it's just ambient noise, which you can expect from places like these. And yeah, I mean, this is the final section of the game, which is very shootout heavy. And I'm glad that they put this into the game so that I can actually exploit this mod. Although I probably should play something like Call of Duty or Rainbow Six if I wanted to play a game like that. And as you can hear right there, somebody either lobbed a grenade or was trying to lob a grenade. And yeah, be careful of that. I mean, Call of Duty wasn't the first game that started the trend of the martyrdom drop, you know? The multiplayer perk. Drop a grenade when you die. Now, right now, right here, I was actually trying to make sure that, you know, this area was in the darkness so that I could set up an ambush from a better vantage point. But I ended up dropping to the floor anyway. So yeah, I just thought I'll proceed with the game as I have been doing up until now as a tactical shooter.
I cannot wait for more.
This section of the game, I mean this entire level in itself, it's sort of like they were pushing you to play it, you know? With all the combat that you get possibly could, because this like so much ammunition all around, so many different kinds of weapons and you know, grenades and everything. I mean, all you can ask for. Just name it, you have it all. So, another trick that I learned, that if you want to have more bullets, reload your gun first and then pick up the bullets. You'll be able to carry a total of 150 rounds in such a case. And I never could figure out how they can just magically tell where I am. Or how they can tank like 4 or 5, 6 rounds to the body. I mean, these rounds can easily penetrate level 2, level 3 vests. And unless these guys are literally wearing like, you know, armor plates, there is no way they can actually take that many rounds and keep standing. But I guess that's just one of the ways the game has been balanced. In the fact that you have just as much health as the enemies do, and one headshot is all it takes. So, like I said, I've been exploring this level quite a lot, and also, like I said, there's an abundance of supply in this particular level, like throughout, not just this section. I mean, this section goes overboard with it, gives you more than you can handle, just in case you need it, but. Yeah, even without that, there's like tons of supply. I was about to say I am sort of lucky that I didn't get shot, but I got shot just as I was about to say it. So, anyway, I sort of decided to become a grenadier for a little while. I was trying to get that guy, you know, up there with the grenade, but my grenades never reached there. Strangely enough, it bounced off the top of the window, it bounced off the wall underneath the window, but it never went through the wall. Huh, strange indeed. And apparently, you only get like 4 grenades from these boxes. Which makes me wonder how I got 6 in the first place. Maybe I picked up one from somebody's satchel. But at any rate, it is nigh impossible to sneak through the section. I decided to try, you know, the setup which I did for my normal playthroughs, using a wall mine on the walls here, and just shooting one guy out with the lights out in this room. But yeah, I just decided to go with the grenade trick instead, because I mean, this mod just makes shooting filthily easy. I mean, it almost feels like you're cheating with an aimbot of sorts. I mean, the shooting is just that smooth. Plus, you know, having knowledge of how the enemies in the game work and which parts they're gonna take, just because you've played it before, like multiple times before, like in my case 5 or 6 times, is overpowered. For all the effort that it only took out one guy, that grenade. So, sort of disappointed, but I feel like the grenades get underpitched in this game. Like, they show you that the grenade is gonna go long, but it ends up going shorter than that. Oh yeah, there's another medikit on this wall. And just look at how much ammo there is all around the level. It's abundant. There's another guy that we need to watch out for, who comes through that door over there, which you just saw, and who I'll be shooting from the shadows. And for whatever reason, I decided to pick up this wall mine, even though it serves no purpose. And as you can see, for the sake of ease with the night vision, I don't know if it would actually work that way or not, but the color green, it shines more brightly on the night vision to indicate perhaps that it is, you know, safe to disarm. However, I feel like the color red, which would be brighter on the night vision, primarily because of how this gun has a very interesting reloading mechanism. I mean, the bullets just pop all the way out, and I don't know how many bullets there are in the gun, but they all just pop out at the same time, and I don't know if it even uses magazines or anything like that. And I'm also curious about how you reload the gun, because I need to pay more attention to it, perhaps when I play Chaos Theory. This stage could have been done far better. Like, as you can see, I shoot that guy, and I shoot this guy, and I shoot that guy again. And yeah, I could have played it much better, but then again, this game, the enemies in this game aren't really geared towards shootouts either. They're mostly, they're pretty dumb when it comes to shootouts. Unlike the enemies in Chaos 3, they will actively flank you and hunt you down. So, that game is something else. I mean, I'm actually, with this mod, empowered by this mod, I'm really looking forward to playing Chaos 3 for that bit. So that poor guy gets shot at and he doesn't even know that he's being shot at. And then he gets shot in the shoulder and just decides to shake it off. And the next time he's shot, he goes down. I mean, it's don't get me wrong, it's a sad scene, but it's I just find it very comical. And I just couldn't see the enemy here for the life of me. Finally decided to turn on the night visions, and the enemy disappeared behind the steel bars. Now the thing about this section is you don't really need to shoot all these people. There's supposed to be another guy there, except, you know, he's well hidden. And there's like a shortcut that you can use. I'm actually looking for that guy, but I won't find him until later. There's a shortcut that you can use. You can just run into the wall and wall jump over onto the roof. You don't need to go anywhere else, so... And there's also a shortcut to our right. You can just jump onto those boxes. You don't need to take this long way around. So yeah, the guy's here. And I do believe these are the only two enemies in this section. Nobody else. And the music dies accordingly to suggest the same. At any rate, yeah, I got turned around there a little. I was searching for where the ladder is for us to go upstairs. But yeah, one of the key differences that I noticed between this version and the PS2 version is that Wilkes isn't up here on the roof engaged in a shootout. It's sort of like a hot extraction where the Ospreys is floating in the air and there are enemies all around and there's like a stack of boxes in the middle. And you don't really need to kill the enemies, but you need to like climb onto the stack of boxes and then jump into the Osprey for the mission to be over. But anyway, that's that for this mission, and let's head over to the debriefing now. Kalinatek Building, Langley, Virginia, USA, November 1st, 2004, 0211 hours. The encryption key retrieved from Ivan allows Grimmsdotir to trace a data stream back to a nuclear power plant on the Kola Peninsula of northern Russia. American intelligence's first solid lead on the whereabouts of Kumbin Nikoladze. Now, as you can see here, this mission, the ending, you know, brief of this mission, we were basically able to find information, find an encryption key which let us decrypt the communication signals that Nikoladze was using. And it turns out that a lot of his data traffic was coming from, the Kola Peninsula of, it's a place in Russia, basically. Now, here's the problem. I don't know what happened, but they decided to cut this level out. I mean, I don't know whether this was a last-minute decision or something, or maybe they were just sloppy about it, but as you can see, they never really bothered to change the, you know, any of the other story to make it fit, make ripping this integral part out of the puzzle fit better into the story. They didn't tie up the loose ends, they just let it stay there, just like that. And this sort of breaks the continuity because it's not just this level, if you actually look at the cinematics of the next level, as well as, communications and other, you know, data sticks inside the level, you'll notice that they actually talk about people having raided Nadezhda nuclear power plant and having killed mass in that area. But I guess to compensate for, you know, to tie up loose ends in some fashion, they decided to release the three bonus levels, which are basically Kola Cell, Selka Infiltration, and Selka Submarine. So Anyway, yeah, as much as I want the next mission to be the nuclear power plant, because it was one beautiful mission, but as much as I want it to be a nuclear power plant, I'm afraid I just can't use this mod on the PS2 version of the game. So yeah, they stuck with this. At any rate, I will see you guys in the next video, which will be Chinese Embassy, and hopefully I'll be able to clear, you know, up the story a little better there, who knows, and maybe point out a few other flaws. But until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.